The Commission should play a more prominent role in the climate change negotiation processes and oversee the technical negotiators while providing support to the African Ministerial Conference on Environment. Similarly, to maintain the political momentum and build strategic partnership for the Pan-African event launched at the COP28, including the Africa Green Industrialization Initiative and the Accelerated Partnership for Renewables in Africa, it is important we establish continental steering committees for these initiatives that will provide the required governance and support as the world prepares for the Baku-Belém COP in 2024 and 2025, and submission of a new NDC by 2025 to incorporate plans for scaling up renewables and transitioning from fossil fuels as agreed in Dubai. Let us actualize the message of the Nairobi Declaration and transformative decisions at the COP28. The Nairobi Declaration makes it clear that this requires broadly four categories of action. Two should be by African countries, and two require international collaboration. African countries should lead on one, economic growth and development plans focused on realizing the climate positive growth opportunities in our region. Local and regional policy and regulation to enable investment across various pathways, including adaptation and also in areas of mitigation. There is need to establish links with other processes within the AU as well as the G7 and G20, the COP and various UN assemblies, among others, so as to embed the declaration in wider context. And therefore, it is important for us to pursue what we agreed at the Africa Climate Summit and get to a logical ending and results at the end. As I noted earlier, we presented it at UNGA, COP, and EU Parliament, and even recently at the Italy-Africa Summit. But it has to be a continuous process that keeps the declaration alive and followed up to inform political processes and draw attention to gaps and also opportunities and refine them even as we make progress.